It's an image that seems to have jumped from the vivid imagination of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle and his lost world. But the mysterious jungle-encrusted sinkholes of Belize are no works of fiction. Over 100 of these amazing geological formations punctuate virtually every part of the country, with probably scores more still hidden from view. And as scientists unlock the secrets of these twilight environments and the elaborate cave systems they contain, the tourists are not far behind. It's a classical developmental dilemma. The world's tourists are hungry for adventure, and the one I'm about to embark on is about as real as it gets. But how much traffic can a resource like this withstand without being destroyed? Getting to the mouth of the cave is no easy proposition. The journey begins 300 feet above the floor of this incredible sinkhole. But believe me, I am not looking down.
Yeah, this is a position.
That's a position there. Most people, they panic right over the edge. The edge is the hardest part.
Holy sinkhole!
Once you're on the rope, it goes smoothly.
Okay, I feel like I'm slipping. The look of fear on my face is in no way feigned.
Oh no, I'm definitely gonna do it. Just how I'm gonna get to the bottom.
Feel perfectly safe. Perfectly safe. I gotta get away. Even after all that, to behold the grandeur of this cave for the first time was definitely worth the trip. The cave's magnificence didn't end at the door. Its inner sanctum was like a starlit sky on a clear night. The cave is filled with numerous crystal formations. These here are known as soda straws. They are thin and hollow and can grow up to 7 feet in length.
Why does it glitter like it has?
Those are mineral crystal that reflect when you shine your light on them. During the rainy season, there is a lot of water going over it, so there's a thin layer and you cannot see it very clearly. But during this time of the year, it's very sparkly.
Did Mayans fear the cave? Or did they have a lot of respect for the cave?
Very much so. It would be only the priest and the shaman and the royal family that would move into the underworld to do their sacred ceremonies. And even up to now, there is a superstitious belief that it is haunted. The local people don't go into caves.
But the possibility of ghosts in the darkness hasn't kept the curious from exploring the sinkhole itself. Hundreds of thousands of years ago, when the sinkhole was formed, it created a unique environment. The plants and animals here have been forced to adapt themselves to a set of specialized conditions. With only limited light and shallow soils, the trees tend to be thinner than their counterparts in the rainforest above. This terrarium-like ecosystem does have its advantages, however, as there is plenty of water and the steep walls provide ample protection from the devastating hurricanes which periodically ravage the outside world. With the exception of an occasional human, most large animals tend to avoid this place because of its inaccessibility and scarcity of food. On the other hand, parasitic plants thrive here, and the roots from the trees on the rim plunge hundreds of feet through the humid air in search of the life-giving water below. Recreational caving in Belize was mostly unheard of until a couple of years ago. However, with the recent launching of a media campaign to promote Belize as an adventure destination, the interest in cave exploration has grown significantly.
But those people who are becoming involved in caving have got very little, if any, cave etiquette training.
Ian Anderson, proprietor of the Caves Branch Adventure Company, regularly brings tourists to visit this majestic cave system, which includes over 15 miles of mapped passageways. Anderson admits the traffic inside a cave can be destructive in more ways than one.
Now, what kind of adverse effects are we talking about here? Just touching everything, going everywhere, picking up stuff?
Exactly that. Going everywhere with no concern on the damage that you do to it. Certain caves, as you saw last night, chambers have got spectacular crystalline formations that have taken 20, 30 million years in the formation in total darkness. Now, with the invention of headlamps and the interest in caving, we go into those chambers. And people who do not know what they're doing as guides or have proper cave etiquette will allow people to walk all over those entire chambers, carrying heavy loads of dirt and mud on their boots over all that pristine crystal. When I see uncontrolled, unlimited access into caves, which is what some people are suggesting right now should be allowed, and I see the damage that's being done to nature's most awesome creations, and then our national heritage of the Mayan ceremonial sites being removed by individuals who are not guided by ethical guides or have no guides at all, then I find it very disheartening that this type of activity is taking place within the caves of Belize. We have a lot of guides right now that are going out and working as cave guides that have had absolutely no training in cave etiquette, cave safety, or cave rescue at all. And those are just accidents waiting to happen, disasters waiting to happen.
With that in mind, every year for the past 5 years, Anderson has invited cave rescue instructor Bruce Hagen to Belize to teach guides here the highly technical skills needed to evacuate an injured caver to safety. To date, no one in Belize has reported being seriously hurt while inside a cave. But both Anderson and Hagen agree it's only a matter of time.
Well, Belize has beautiful world-class caves, and they're just some of the best, most wonderful caves I've ever seen in my caving experience, but they're also some of the most dangerous caves. It's real easy to slip and fall inside of a cave. They're very slippery, unstable surfaces. Just a moment's inattention or inexperience could cause the average person to fall and suffer a serious injury. There are large river systems, a lot of them, a lot of unstable breakdown because there hasn't been a lot of exploration in the caves. The best routes through the cave haven't always been selected, so the people that are quite often traversing these caves are the first people in maybe thousands of years to walk there, and if there are unstable rock sections, on treacherous footing areas, on rivers with unknown currents, they're not going to know about it until they're walking there.
Marcus Cocol is a member of the Belize Cave and Rescue Team. Ironically, before coming to Caves Branch a year ago, Cocol had never been inside a cave.
It feels very special to see where my ancestors were once doing their very sacred ceremonies.
Today, Cocol sees the protection of his heritage as an integral part of his profession.
Keeping the integrity of the cave is something that we explain to them, how fragile the environment is. And when they start actually seeing what's in there, you know, they get to appreciate it, and we keep people in line.
As to keeping people out of trouble, Cocol says it's about focusing on the task at hand.
We are trained to take care of the people. We are very careful with them because we have done the training. We know what it's like. It's very hard. It's not a fun situation to get into. So we put out that extra effort out there to take care of our people.
But it's the growing quantity of those people and their appetite for adventure that has travel agents rubbing their hands and experienced naturalists shaking in their boots. The once remote and mysterious sinkholes increasingly find themselves perched on the edge of expanding agricultural and resort development.
There are literally thousands of caves scattered all over Belize, many of them still waiting to be discovered. But as more visitors begin to explore this amazing underworld, our responsibility to care for Belize's caves is even greater. Reporting for News 5, I am Janelle Chanona.